is Husna Mbarak. I work for Food and Agriculture Organization, based in the country office, Kenya. I work around land and natural resource governance within the FAO. But the conference, I think this is the third conference, and one thing about it is the theme this year actually has been one of the best themes, because it's high time we speak about corruption within the land sector. Looking at statistics, the bigger part of corruption in any country is governance, and the land and natural resources falls in as the main theme or the main area where corruption is taking place. And, if, for example, you look into the formal justice system, you get 80 to 90% of the cases in the system are all land and natural resources, and are all geared up to corruption. The institutions put in place by countries, they perform, but if you look at their performance and you start putting a scorecard to them, they are performing less. Why? Because corruption has gotten in one way or the other. So I think it's high time now this becomes one of the themes, and we discuss it openly in a way that it can really curb the problems we're facing in our countries. We're not able to plan for our resources, we're not able to adjudicate for our resources, we're not able to even make decisions for our resources, neither even making sure the implementation of policy we put in place and laws are done, just because of this corruption. And it's all in the entire chain, from bottom up, from up bottom, it doesn't matter. As the little as a woman paying a bribe to get a title, that's already corruption. So it's high time that we discuss this. And I feel the theme should not be only left for this year. Probably it's important, because that is one of the main challenges we're facing in Africa, the African continent. And one of the other ways we can really solve this, apart from discussing it here, is to put up declaration, to put up binding instruments for us to be able to work in our countries. They can be of short durations, but it's something we need to bind our leaders, we need to bind our people to be able to really cover these aspects of corruption. Because the most affected are the communities, and the most affected are the marginalized, who cannot have a voice to speak. So it's important. One thing about this conference which has brought forward is we're only discussing corruption as one of the main problems, or the only problem we face in Africa within the land sector, but also putting up measures, looking at solutions on the best way to work. We have very good practices, we have got very good cases we can learn from, very beautiful lessons learned from not only Africa, even the entire world, we can learn from and be able to implement some of these things. One important fact means that we need to know what we are managing, what we are governing, and from there now we really need to look into data. So the moment we get the data, we are able to see what is there and how much we can be able to plan for, how much we can be able to allocate for, and be able actually even to govern it. So this is very, very important. And I would also wish that as much as we are discussing at this level, probably one of the biggest goals will not only be, I can see a very big representation of the traditional leadership or the customary leadership in this conference. But one important fact remains, we need the executive on board. We need the presidents, the ministers, the people who really look into the aspects of policies and the implementation of the legislation and the executive of each of the country. So as they are able to adopt, they're able to customize at their own, whatever lessons learned come from, their own recommendations come from here. Because as much as we have all these representations, still we don't have the main decisions makers of each of the countries involved in this conference. So that is my call, and I wish this talk is done openly at all levels. Let it be an affirmative action actually to reduce corruption within the land sector. And we have a lot of openness and transparency, and most of it accountability within the processes. Thank you very much.